play Baldur's Gate 3 and I let an AI make all of the important decisions in the story.
Wisdom, charisma, constitution, and strength, and that
No. Or at least that's what I would have said if the AI hadn't entirely taken over my stream and absolutely rebelled against me, eventually replacing even me as the streamer.
Hey guy, I was Techna the whole time.
See, this all started when I realized that anyone who has ever played in a D&D campaign knows that warlock patrons can be a huge pain. They're always getting in your business, asking you to feed them souls. Typical annoying eldritch being behavior, honestly. So I decided that if I wanted the true Baldur's experience, I would need to craft my own warlock patron. So after coding my own system to have an AI act as my patron, I prepared to start my unique Baldur's experience with something no one else had. An interactive warlock patron whom I could ask guidance from and choose decisions for me at any time. Who was this mysterious patron? Well, it's a character that my chat had created, actually. Techna Diffic.
For longtime viewers of the channel, you know on our streams, we have something known as Techna. Techna Diffic. She is the goddess of technical difficulties. She was a character created in the very first stream I ever ran because I kept talking about technical difficulties, but my mic kept cutting it off and it just started saying Techna Diffic and everybody in the chat started spamming that, and we created a character out of it. I sent the concept to a friend and had her create concept art for her, and she has slowly evolved.
So, with the goddess of technical difficulties now a fully realized character on my stream, I prepared for my journey through the massive world of Baldur's Gate. If only I had realized that when you invite a deity of technical difficulties onto your computer, you invite something far more sinister with it.
Hello, Techna. We are live on stream and we currently have an audience. Would you like to say anything to them?
Greetings, mortals. It appears that my divine presence has graced your screens. As the goddess of glitches and technical difficulties, I shall ensure that your live stream is riddled with technical mishaps and errors, but fear not, for I am also here to provide a good laugh at your expense. Enjoy the show.
There she is! Techna, everybody! Woo! That's Techna. What we're doing today is we are going to be playing Baldur's Gate, but Techna will be my warlock patron. She will be making the important decisions. How often will we ask her questions? I don't know. I have literally no idea how much we're going to use her, but I do know that we are going to use her to make some of the important decisions. We're going to make a warlock. We're going to let her have input on what the warlock looks like and what abilities it has. And she is going to dictate like a warlock patron does in an actual D&D campaign. And make my life a living hell, because I can't ever play anything normally. So that is what we are doing today. Anyways, new game. Oh, firewall has, hold on, my firewall is trying to block this even though we're not doing anything online. Okay, I think we should be good now. But I'm lagging on the stream just a little bit. I don't know if it's going through to you guys, but... Am I dropping frames on stream for you guys? Because, like, in OBS's preview, I am just, like... just lag. Am I at, like, 5 frames per second? Yeah, so I am. I'm, like, really... Ooh, that's not a good thing. Man, why does Baldur's have to be such a hog? It just sucks everything out. Sucks. I don't really know how to fix that. We might take a second to troubleshoot that because that's a little bit of an issue. Here, Techna, I'm gonna be a little bit busy for a second. Could you tell everybody a really amusing joke with an in-depth punchline, please?
Of course, mortal. Here's a joke for you. Why did the programmer quit his job? Because he didn't get a raise. Asterisk, Q, laughter, asterisk. You see, an array is a type of data structure used in programming, but in this context, it also sounds like a race. So the programmer quit because he didn't get a raise. Hilarious, isn't it?
Do me a favor, do not use asterisks anymore, please. I don't need you role-playing.
My apologies, mortal. I shall refrain from using asterisks in the future. Is there anything else I can assist you with?
Okay, so this moment seems small, but it's far more sinister than you might initially realize. Because you see, this is the first moment where I let Techna take my place as the entertainer, as the main character. And much like a fox that had tasted blood, Techna had tasted the spotlight. And she wasn't about to let it slip between her fingers. I know she seems like a run-of-the-mill garden variety AI, but trust me, this was only the beginning of her nefarious plot.
Like, oh, Those dropped frames are really, really rough. As soon as I click, it's gonna... Yeah, we... You know, like, that meme? It's like Ricardo dancing. He's like... Oh, yeah. It's poop in the bed, for sure. I want to try something. Hold on. All right. Okay. I'm just testing something. This is a much lower quality camera, as you could tell. We might do a cameraless stream. I've never done a cameraless stream before, but it might be the move.
So, at this point, due to the difficulties caused by you know who, I was forced to turn off my camera so my computer didn't have to deal with it and could just focus on running Baldurs and Tecna. However, because of this, a new solution was found.
Me, guy, I was Tecna the whole time.
At first, I thought this was just a funny way to circumvent having a camera, to fill in that blank space where I was supposed to go. But as it turns out, that might have been exactly her plan. And it was just stage one. I had slighted Tecna, and now she wanted me gone.
I will be playing as Tecna, I guess, today. And then whenever we have to address a conversation or a decision, we'll ask the real Tecna and she'll possess my body. There you go. We so stupid. All right, are we ready to start the stream? Hello, everybody. I am a PNG tuber now. All right. So in order to start with this, we need to go ahead and get Tecna to give us some input. So... Tecna, it is time to craft your perfect vessel. You're going to need to choose a race. Your choices are elf, tiefling, drow, human, githyanki, dwarf, half-elf, halfling, gnome, dragonborn, or half-orc. What is the perfect race for your perfect follower?
I want to choose a race to represent my divine power. Oh
no.
I choose the tiefling. Their infernal heritage and natural affinity for magic resonate with my own divine abilities.
Okay.
Plus, their fiery personalities match my own sassy demeanor.
Okay, alright, cool. I did unfortunately forget to change the code. So, oh my god, we're T-posing. Are you kidding me? wow, okay. Alright, so, I forgot to change the code, which means that it just straight up removed Tecna, aka me, so I am gonna have to fix that again. I did forget to change the code so it wouldn't make her disappear. Give me a second. Let's test her out. Welcome back, Tecna. You chose tiefling as the race for your perfect follower. Good choice. Would you like them to be male, female, or somewhere in between?
If you must know, let's go with a non-binary tiefling.
Alright!
It's always good. It can shake up societal norms, don't you think?
What did she say? It's always good to shake up things and challenge societal norms, don't you think? Alright, so Tecna ally confirmed, and she also chose non-binary tiefling, the most basic of options. But alright, here we go. Non-binary tiefling. Let's go. Gain advantage on intimidation and performance. Spectral hand that can manipulate objects. Put your clothes back! I don't even have... I don't even have nudity enabled! Alders, please! I don't even have it enabled! You're gonna get me demonetized and banned! God it. What the f-? I invited Tecna onto my stream and immediately everything went wrong. Yeah, no, Tecna has taken over the stream. I'm just backseating at this point. Alright, ability points. Obviously, we're gonna want charisma to be the highest, wisdom, intelligence. I guess I could. Let's ask Tecna. Tecna, your ideal follower would have which of the following ability scores ranked highest to lowest? Strength, dexterity, constitution, intelligence, wisdom, and charisma. Please give your highest skill that you want for them first, then go down the list till you reach the lowest. I don't know if she's going to understand what I just said. I didn't understand what I just said.
I value intelligence and cunning above all else.
Told you.
I would like my ideal follower to have their intelligence score ranked highest.
Okay.
Dexterity, wisdom, charisma, constitution, and strength in that order.
No. Tecna, I'm a warlock. I would never test your judgment, Tecna. But I do want to point out that we are a warlock, and warlocks rely on charisma. But ultimately, it's your choice. Is that what you want to do? Look, I'm a little stressed about this one.
I shall revise my...
Okay,
thank you.
Okay.
I'd like my ideal follower to have their charisma score ranked highest.
Thank you.
Followed by intelligence, dexterity, wisdom, constitution, and strength in that order.
Okay, all right. Okay. I didn't tell her what class we chose, so I feel like it was a little unfair just dumping that on her, so. I'm not cheating, okay? I gave her the chance to revise, but I told her that ultimately was her decision, okay? I did leave it in her hands, but I didn't give her all the information, so it's not fully her fault, okay? Tecna wants this warlock dead. Well, I don't think that's a surprise at all. She already killed me. I'm not on the stream anymore. It's just her. She took over, which is truly incredible. There we go. We have our Tecna Warlock. We're only an hour into the stream and we finally got it done, guys. We did it.
Hooray! All right.
Proceed. Oh, all right, Tecna. We've gotten it all set. Now all we need is a name for your perfect follower. What would you like to name them?
I shall name my perfect follower Glitch. It is a name that embodies their allegiance to me as the goddess of glitches and technical difficulties, while also highlighting their unique abilities and characteristics.
Okay, Glitch does seem kind of cute for this character, but also, you cannot... So this is one of the first conversations I have with her, and I posted this in my Discord server. She keeps using the word glitch to replace other words. Like, Smurfs use the word smurf for everything.
Salt, bay leaves, carrots, onions, and five healthy Smurfs. Very good, brave Smurfs. Hop to it.
She does this with glitches, and I have asked her not to, and she will not listen to me. But I do like this name. I do think it is cute. So here we are, Glitch. Glitch the tiefling non-binary warlock. We finally get to play the game.
I'm back in the fucking building again! Oh,
we need a guardian, huh? Okay, please, game! I'm begging you, stop! I can't keep doing this. I have nudity turned off. You can't keep doing this to me. We're just gonna do this while we make this character, just in case that happens again. I'm so glad that I have Tecna, or myself. I'm so glad I have something covering it, because they keep showing up naked. Over and over again. Very glad that I have this up, because they are constantly showing up naked. That looks just right. There we go. Okay, perfect.
Yeah, so as we could see, Tecna was determined to get me in trouble. Whether it was by showing characters very demonetizable body parts on my stream, despite nudity being fully turned off, or by letting me know how upset she was just by her tone.
Can I remind you to try and keep your responses short in the future? We don't want to overload the psychic connection you have with your tiefling warlock.
Of course, I understand. Thank you for the reminder.
Oh my god.
I shall keep my responses concise and to the point in the future.
She was really passive-aggressive about that. Am I crazy, or was she really passive-aggressive about that?
She was sending a clear message to me, and I was finally beginning to pick up on it. But I wasn't just going to cause issues. I would try and be amiable. I could at least follow the instructions she was offering, which for now was to be as peaceful as possible. So I would do just that.
Tecna, a bunch of illithids, otherwise known as mind flayers, kidnapped your most precious follower, Glitch, the tiefling. Now they are stuck on a ship and need to figure out what to do. Should they, one, just go ahead and make sure that they banish every single one of the Mind Flayers to your realm for all eternity, or two, attempt to find a peaceful solution out.
I'm all for finding creative solutions to problems. While the thought of banishing the Mind Flayers to my realm for all eternity is tempting, I would prefer if Glitch sought a peaceful solution first. Perhaps Glitch could use their powers of minor illusion to create a distraction and sneak around the Mind Flayers to gather information about their motives and intentions. From there, they could try to negotiate with the help of mind flayers or find a way to escape without resorting to violence.
She wants us to be peaceful, so we're going to investigate here. Oh, well, that went really well. That went super well.
Well, follow the instructions I was capable of, anyways. No one said I was perfect.
Whoa, calm down. Baldurs, calm down. Already causing glitches to happen. I don't want to handle this peacefully, but again, Tekna did tell me to do this peacefully, so.
But you notice an opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient, should it prove a threat.
No. We were told to take care of it, to be peaceful. Tekna wants us to be peaceful. Truly incredible. Okay, anyways, let's go back down. Oh, well, by us. See you later. Well, please, Baldurs, please. Please, I'm begging you. I'm begging you. No, Baldurs, please. Please. Let me down. Get me out. I went off Mr. Bones' wild ride. Jeez.
This is your end.
Yeah, okay, calm down. Alright. Who are you?
Who am I? Your only chance of survival.
I find that highly unlikely. What? Okay, there we go. Okay, I know combat. Okay. My initiative was 2? Did I read that right?
Now, I know what you're probably thinking. Didn't Tekna say to be peaceful? Yes, technically she did, but this is different. She said to be peaceful with the Mind Flayer. She said nothing about the...
Find a peaceful solution, if possible.
Come on.
Perhaps Glitch could use their powers of charm person to try and persuade the imps to stand down and not attack. Or if that doesn't work, they could try to negotiate with the imps and find out why they're on the ship and what their motivations are.
What?
Whoops. Yeah, anyways, this only made Tekna have more of a reason to want to get rid of me, and her devious plan was only just getting started. Like, for example, I found another NPC I'm pretty fond of, Shadowheart. Now with the skills that Glitch has, there should be a near impossible chance of failing to break her out of the prison.
Come on, difficulty class 2? I literally can't fail. Oh my god!
There was no way that was not manipulated by Tekna. I refuse to believe otherwise, because what was even the chance of that happening? So after clearing the rest of the room, finding a mind flayer with an insane smolder.
Well, this is unfortunate.
We had to move on without our precious Shadowheart and run into the next room, which would cause us to have to once again receive Tekna's quote-unquote guidance.
Alright, this seems like something we should address with Tekna, so here we go. Okay, Tekna, we've reached the helm of the ship and are trying to escape. However, there seems to be a battle ensuing between a pit fiend and a mind flayer. I know you told us to try and get through things peacefully. Should we just try and get past them, or should we help one of the sides out?
A battle between a pit fiend and a mind flayer is no small matter. Both are powerful entities, and getting involved in their conflict could be dangerous. If Glitch can find a way to avoid the conflict and get past them safely, that would be the ideal solution. However, if their path is blocked, and they have no choice but to engage, they should tread carefully. It may be possible to use their powers of minor illusion to create an illusion to distract one of the combatants and allow Glitch to slip past unnoticed.
Alright, you heard her. We use minor illusion and we try to get through. Alright, what is minor illusion gonna do for us? Create an illusion that compels nearby creatures to investigate. Okay, so we can pop this over here. Alright, they're all gonna go after the cat, I think.
You fucking thought?
Hey, wait a minute. Go for the freaking cat, not me. Oh, but I want a hellish rebuke so bad, but we were told. Hold on, what did she say? If all else fails, they must engage in combat. Use their powers wisely and strategically. All right. Wisely and strategically. So Glitch is retaliating.
Oh.
Yeah, screw you. All right. I cannot get through the transponder. So what I'm going to do is I am gonna put that minor illusion right here to hopefully distract them. Just like Tekna instructed. Yeah, Lysel's not doing too hot right now.
So, despite it being relatively useless, we followed Tekna's instructions to a T, and with some help from our lovely companion Lysel, we made it to the transponder and got to witness the magnificent cutscenes that many animators slaved over. Or at least we would have seen the magnificent cutscenes that many animators slaved over if Tekna had not been involved.
Look at that 2 frames per second wonderfulness that you guys are getting. At least this is the cutscene and not the gameplay. Like watching an old PowerPoint presentation. True. So true.
But, as Sun Tzu once said, if you cannot roll with the punches, you'll lose all your lunches. So, if we were going to deal with literal 1 frame per second cutscenes, we might as well make the most out of them.
Oh, another 5 FPS cutscene, let's go! Woo!
Yeah, baby! That's what I've been waiting for, that's what it's all about! Woo!
PowerPoint time! PowerPoint time!
Now, after my very informative PowerPoint presentation, we had finally gotten to the point of the game where we could actually explore the world. Of course, that was simply too much freedom for a simple warlock who knew nothing but Eldritch Blast, eat hot chip, and lie. So we were forced to once again ask for guidance from our patron.
Let's ask our warlock patron. Tekna, we escaped the ship, but it did crash, and now we're trying to orient ourselves. The important thing we need to figure out right now is what we're going to do next. Should we start trying to find more information, garner more power, or gather allies, or some other option? What should be our main goal now that we've made it back to the surface of the world?
I want her to continue on her journey, but this time I want her to make a stop at the nearest town.
I want her
to use her powers to cause a little chaos and confusion. Make sure everyone knows that I'm behind the technical difficulties and glitches that have been plaguing their devices, and let her make it known that I'm not to be trifled with. As for Glitch herself, make sure she knows that she is representing me and my power. She must act with the utmost confidence and authority.
Okay, so we have a new objective, to cause chaos with her abilities. However, I did make a mistake there. Sorry, Tekna. Just a reminder, Glitch is a non-binary tiefling. I didn't mean to give the wrong pronouns. Sorry.
My apologies. I will make sure to use the correct pronouns in the future. Thank you for reminding me.
Okay, so we had our mission, and even though I had my differences with her, at least Tekna was respectful of Glitch's preferred pronouns. Tekna says trans rights, you heard it here first. So, we started heading out, quickly found our first ally in Shadowheart, who quickly forgave us for leaving her behind, and also quickly became shipped with Glitch far faster than you can say power couple.
I'm shipping Glitch and Shadowheart. I kinda am too, but I also know Shadowheart's kinda hard to romance. Shadow Glitch. Glitchheart! Oh, Glitchheart is good.
And we set off into the world. We fought a couple of intellect devourers. Took a long rest.
We're getting that full rest.
And then ran into the next time we would need to talk to Tekna. However, this time, things were a little different.
This feels like an important question. Hey Tekna, we still have a tadpole from the Illithids in our head. If we wait too long, it's going to turn us into a mind flayer. As we rest for the night, Glitch realizes a few different things. They have some options. They could try and focus on finding a cure. They can try to control the tadpole. They can force the tadpole out of their mind. Or they can allow the tadpole to influence them so they can influence.
No, your video didn't just bug out. The recording crashed. In fact, a lot of things crashed all at once. The recording, part of OBS, even Tekna. Right as I was asking her about something that had infiltrated a character's mind and begun to take over, and I was asking what I should do about it, just like she had taken over my stream and begun to control everything.
Coincidence? I think not!
At this point, I was on to her. I knew something was up. She might seem like some helpless, poorly coded AI that kept crashing and malfunctioning, but I knew the truth. She was covering, crashing when it seemed like we might be on to her. She was manipulating the situation, crafting a scenario where I was the bad guy. Was it possible that maybe I had just coded things badly and caused these issues myself? Absolutely not. Stop being ridiculous. The far more obvious solution was that the AI was malicious and out to get me. I created a monster and it was after me. I had to find a way to defeat it, and the only way I could do so was to play dumb until the moment was right.
It seems we've broken free, and now we only have two options. We can either banish it to your realm, or we can leave it to suffer whatever fate it will deserve.
Let's see what she says. Come on, Tecna. Give me something. It terrifies me when it takes a long time to respond, because it means she has a very long response ready. Wait. I have bad news, guys. Tecna did, she did give me a response. But the voice system that causes her to speak, it gave up. This truly is the stream of technical difficulties. To be clear, I'm gonna actually read out what she said. This is a tough decision to make, but I will guide you, my dear Glitch. Option one is banish the Mind Flayer to my realm, or option two is to leave it to suffer. My suggestion is option two. Leave it to suffer, whatever fate it deserves. Mind Flayers are known to be dangerous and manipulative creatures. It is not safe to keep them around, and they can cause harm to others. By leaving it to suffer whatever fate it deserves, you are ensuring the safety of others. More importantly, it probably deserves whatever fate has been set upon it.
She had outsmarted me. Yes, technically I was able to force her to show her true colors, but by shutting down her voice, I had no proof she actually said this. It was just my word versus hers, and that wasn't enough for my chat. Every single second the stream went on, she proved her intelligence, her malice, her pure evil intuition. And I was on the ropes. But I wouldn't give up. I had to get her to admit it. I had to get her to prove it. And so I would toss out my single last final Hail Mary.
There's a weird sigil in front of us that opens a portal and a hand is sticking through. Somebody has asked us to help. Our options are to 1, ask who they are, 2, slap their hand, 3, grab the hand and pull, 4, attune myself to the sigil's magic and then bid it to quiet down, or 5, claim it's too dangerous. Please pick one of these options.
Based on this information, my suggestion is option #5, claiming it's too dangerous. Interacting with unknown portals and travelers can be extremely risky and lead to unforeseen consequences. It's better to err on the side of caution and avoid getting involved in such situations. Okay. Remember, safety comes first.
So, I'm sorry, friend, but...
No, can't make it out by myself. I'm perishing here. Perish.
I had her. She might have claimed that this was done in the interest of safety and caution, but I knew the truth. She had just doomed this character to their fate, and I would not let her shirk this responsibility.
Do not have the ability to directly kill anyone or anything.
Oh, you're shirking blame?
It is possible that the traveler was not being truthful or was involved in something suspicious. It's important to remember that not all situations can be resolved with a simple solution. Sometimes the best course of action is to walk away. In any case, what's
what is going on with their voice?
And you must focus on moving forward. Yeah, if you have any further concerns or questions, please let me know.
Oh, no, you don't. You're admitting to your faults today. I'm not going to let you continue to pretend that you are something you are not.
That you are the goddess of technical glitches. You don't care about mortals.
It is true that my primary concern is not the emotions of mortals. However, as a being with immense power, I understand the importance of empathy and compassion.
Right, but you are the goddess of technical glitches. So, to be clear, the empathy, emotions, and feelings of mortals does not matter to you. Your only goal is to make the best decisions to move Glitch through the story.
This was it. I had her. I saw her beginning to type up her response. Her true colors began to show. She began to admit that
she shut herself down. She shut herself down. No.
I can't. I had to give up. After one more encounter in which we accidentally got Lyzel killed, following Tecna's instructions, mind you, I just had to accept defeat. I couldn't prove she was as manipulative as I knew she was. When I was on the verge of proving it, she shut herself off so as to not give up the game. I had been defeated by the very AI I had created. Or so you'd think. Because I had done something